Dear students, previous classes integration fundamental formulas and some more problems discussed. So today integration of the trigonometric functions formulas and discuss the some more problems. So first of all, trigonometric functions of the integration. So integration of the trigonometric formulas so I am comparing to derivatives to integration. First of all, d by dx of sin x that is equal to cos x. So derivative of sin x is equal to cos x. And now integration of cos x is equal to sin x plus c. So derivative of sin x is equal to cos x and integration of cos x is equal to sin x. And again d by dx of cos x is equal to so minus sin x and integration of sin x is equal to sin x dx is equal to minus cos x plus c. And sin x antiderivative is equal to cos x and cos x antiderivative is equal to sin x. And again d by dx of tan x. So now d by dx of tan x is equal to secant square of x and integration secant square of x is equal to so tan x plus c. Derivative of tan x is equal to secant square of x and secant square of dx is equal to tan x plus c. Next, d by dx of cot x. Now d by dx of cot x is equal to minus cosine square of x. Now integration of cosine square of x is equal to dx is equal to minus cot x plus c. And remaining now d by dx of sec x. So that is equal to sec x into tan x. Now derivative of sec x is equal to sec x into tan x and integration of sec x into tan x is equal to so sec x plus c. Last, now d by dx of cosec x. Now d by dx of cosec x is equal to so minus cosec x into cot x and integration of cosec x into cot x dx is equal to minus cosec x so plus c. And derivative of cosec x is equal to minus cosec x into cot x and integration cosec x into cot x is equal to minus cosec x plus c. Right, trigonometric functions with derivative and integration. And remaining now inverse trigonometric functions. Now first of all, d by dx of sin cos of x. So first of all, d by dx of sin x is equal to cos x and d by dx of sin cos of x is equal to 1 by under root of 1 minus x square. So d by dx of sin cos of x is equal to 1 by 1 minus x square under root of, then integration of 1 by under root of 1 minus x square dx is equal to sin cos of x plus c. Right, next, derivative of d by dx of cos inverse of x. Now d by dx of cos inverse of x is equal to minus 1 by under root of 1 minus x square. Right, so given antiderivative of integration. Now integration of 1 by under root of 1 minus x square dx is equal to minus cos inverse of x plus c. Next, d by dx of tan inverse of x. So d by dx of tan inverse of x is equal to 1 by 1 plus x square. Now antiderivative of integration. Now integration of 1 by 1 plus x square dx is equal to tan inverse of x plus c. Right, next, d by dx of cot inverse of x. So d by dx of cot inverse of x is equal to minus 1 by 1 plus x square. Now remaining integration. So integration of 1 by 1 plus x square dx is equal to minus cot inverse of x plus c. Right. Next, d by dx of sec inverse of x. So d by dx of sec inverse of x is equal to 1 by x into under root of x square minus 1. So remaining integration form. Now integration of 1 by x into under root of x square minus 1 dx is equal to sec inverse of x plus c. Next, last one. Now d by dx is equal to cosec inverse of x. Now cosec inverse of x is equal to minus 1 by x into under root of x square minus 1. Now given integration. Now integration of 1 by x into under root of x square minus 1 dx is equal to minus cosec inverse of x plus c. Right? Given first of all derivative of trigonometric functions and integration. So derivative of trigonometric inverse function and okay. So given trigonometric integration formulas by using some more problems. Now first of all integration x plus 4 by 1 plus x square dx. Now let I is equal to integration x into dx plus now integration 4 we get common integration 1 by 1 plus x square into dx. Now 2 are both values, then partial fractions of x into dx plus 4 into 1 by 1 plus x square dx. Now x dx. Now given by using formula x to the power of n. So now x square by 2 plus 4 of. Now underline given direct principle integration 1 by 1 plus x square. So 1 by 1 plus x square is equal to tan inverse of x plus c. Now since integration 1 by 1 plus x square dx is equal to tan inverse of x plus c. So we get the answer. First one. Next one. Second one. Second one is integration e power of log of 1 plus tan square x dx. Now let I is equal to integration e power of log of. So 1 plus tan square x into dx. So first of all 1 plus tan square x. Now trigonometric basic fundamental formula. Now identity formula since secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. That implies 1 plus tan square theta is equal to secant square theta. So by using first trigonometric identity formula 1 plus tan square x is equal to secant square of. Now integration e power of log of secant square of x into dx. Now that implies integration secant square of x dx. Now since e power of log base e is equal to 1. So right, e power of log of secant square x is equal to integration secant square of x. Now integration secant square. Okay. Right. E power of log of secant square x. So is equal to secant square of. Now since e power of log e f of x is equal to f of x. So therefore secant square of x dx is equal to tan x plus. Next, now third one. Third one, now integration sin square x by 1 plus cos square x. Let now I is equal to sin square x by 1 plus cos square x. So into dx. Now denominator is 1 plus cos square x. Therefore, now integration sin square x by 2 cos square of x into dx. Now since trigonometric identity formula of cos square is equal to 2 cos square minus 1. So that implies minus 1 is go to left side, 1 plus cos square is equal to 2 cos square a. So that implies 1 plus cos square x is equal to 2 cos square x. Then 1 by 2 we get common. Therefore sin square x by cos square x is equal to tan square x. So into dx. Therefore 1 by 2. Right? 1 by 2 into tan square of x into dx. Now it is identity from the integration tan square of x. So that is equal to 1 by 2 secant square of x minus 1 into dx. Now since from the secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. Now there are two parts. First of all 1 by 2 integration secant square of x dx minus 1 by 2 integration 1 dx. Now, integration secant of x is equal to 1 by 2 tan x minus 1 by 2 dx is equal to x by 2 plus c. So, we get answer. Now, third one computed. Next one, fourth one. Fourth one, now integration secant square of x minus cos x plus x square into dx. So, now integration three parts. First of all, secant square of x minus cos x plus x square into dx. Right, each one integration of n. Now, y is equal to integration secant square of x dx minus integration cos x dx. So, plus integration x square into dx. Right. Then from up, now integration secant square of x is equal to tan x minus integration cos x is equal to sin x. So plus x square dx is equal to x cube by 3 plus is the answer, fourth one. Next, last one, fifth one. Now I is equal to integration under root of 1 minus cos 2x dx. So, integration under root of 1 minus cos 2x dx. So, that implies, so first of all, now 1 is equal to, so it's identity formula, then first formula sin and cos formula. So, integration sin square x plus cos square of x minus cos 2x into dx. So, where 1 is equal to sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So that implies a square plus b square minus. Okay. Right. So a square plus b square. So sin square x plus cos square x minus cos 2x. So cos 2x formula. Now integration sin square x plus cos square x minus cos 2x formula. Now cos square x minus sin square x of dx. So then integration of under root of, so sin square x plus cos square x, so minus the product, so minus cos square x plus minus to minus plus sin square x into dx. So we get minus cos square x plus cos square x, we get cancelled. Now I is equal to integration under root of sin square x plus sin square x, 2 sin square x dx. So square root we can cancel, then root 2 of integration sin x dx. Now root 2 into integration sin x. So minus cos x plus c. So you get the answer. So, root of minus 2 cos x plus.
Yes.
Okay. So integration under root of 1 minus cos 2 x dx is a first method. There is another method, direct principle. Now integration under root of, so 1 minus cos 2x dx is equal to, so integration under root of 2 sin square x dx. Now square root we can cancel, that implies root 2 into integration sin x dx. So that is equal to minus root 2 into cos x plus c. So you can directly into under root of 1 minus cos 2x is equal to 2 sin square x dx. Now square root cancel. Root 2 of sin x dx, now root 2 into cos x plus c.